Today we are in Florida, where iguana populations are at an epic level. The hunt is on, and if all goes as planned, we will leave this place with skins and some of the best white meat in the world. But more so, we will return the natural balance back to the streets and waterways of South Florida.
All right, well, here we are in Florida, obviously, and you can hear jets flying over from above. I can hear cars in the distance, but it's just a jungle along these waterways. These iguanas are here literally by the millions. There are hundreds of square miles that they inhabit now, an invasive species, a real problem for Florida, much like the python. But what we're doing is, we found that there's a good concentration of them along all these waterways. These are irrigation waterways, these are rivers. Anywhere there's water, they concentrate along the edge because they can be safe above the water where predators can't get at them. If you look up ahead of me here, in the mangoes, you can see big ones sleeping in the trees. There's even one down low here. So it's a target-rich environment, I can tell you that.
We hadn't gone 30 yards off the dock when Donovan spotted a giant lurking in the trees. Soaking up the morning sun, he seemed out of place in this garden of beauty. But he wasn't alone. And in no time, we were looking at monsters on both sides of the river. Ugly, yet beautiful. I was quite intrigued. Because these reptiles are so strong, JP was a skeptic, so we gave him the first go-round with my blowgun. With a good hit, the mighty lizard was off and running. Then, to my amazement, he made a jump for it. And even more amazing, they can swim. And boy, are they good at it. But so far, so good.
There you go. That's my first iguana I ever shot with a blowgun. And I gotta tell you, it worked awesome. You see, that's a clean pass through on the vitals with that dart. And I am no experienced blowgun guy by any means, so I'm impressed with that.
The Everglades are now infested with invasive species. They threaten the natural ecosystem. Snakes, fish, plants, and of course iguanas were all introduced by us. Humans, of course. And it's ironic that hunters are the single most effective means of returning the balance back to this fragile environment. Even so, many oppose hunting, and despite the good it brings, constantly threaten the culture of hunting.
This was almost a fluorescent green one. He's out here in the open where I can get a good shot at him. If we don't spook him and he doesn't turn and run, I may have him.
I'm hoping to leave with some of their beautiful skins and delicious white flesh. It's a vital hit, but like snakes and other reptiles, it takes time for the dart to put the lights out. My string attached to the dart acts like a tracking system. When the reptile retreats, he often gets tangled. If not, I can follow the string into the quagmire of brush and find him.
barring there's not a python in here waiting for me, I have managed to get my iguana that was lethally hit. You can see the penetration was beautiful. You couldn't put an X on him and hit him any better. His muscles have tensed up like all reptiles, but another beautiful iguana. I've got snake skin, or iguana skin, and look at the skin on the tail. Won't that be amazing when you take that off of him? All right. Having a great time down here with my guide Donovan, who has put me on iguanas.
And I can promise you, I'm having the time of my life. I'm glad you could join me.
He's making a run for her. He's hit hard. He's going down. He's making a dive for the water.
The young iguana tries to escape, but he's hooked by the dart and becomes entangled. Then falls into the water where we retrieved
him. Water. I got him, boy, and that's a green one. I wanted a green one bad. He tried to run. He was running up the limb, trying to get away from me, but I just put one right over the top of his hind leg, in through his vitals, and out the other side. There we go. Yeah, look at that. Oh, man. What a beautiful trophy. Now that's some skin for the bow limbs that's going to be just absolutely beautiful. If you look up ahead of me here, in the mangoes, you can see big ones sleeping in the trees. There's even one down low here. So it's a target-rich environment, I can tell you that. Atta boy,
nice.
Ten ring.
Oh, come on, back with the boat.
You're like a stinking aborigine with that blowgun, buddy.
Look at the blue head on that.
Yeah! Woo-hoo! What a shot, buddy!
Woo! Look at that.
Very
right
nice.
There. Perfect shot.
And so you think about every one of those is an egg of an iguana that really doesn't have a natural predator out here. All these iguanas that we took today don't really have any natural predators. So all those are going to turn into more iguanas that are going to eat up the natural vegetation. So taking out that iguana right there, we just knocked down about 30 more iguanas.
This guy's a meat eater, the black Mexican rock iguana and the common green iguana. Both are out of control.
And they just keep reproducing and reproducing. Like Donovan said, they don't have natural predators. So they have nothing to even them out, the environment. So they just keep going and going and going.
A country boy can find a use for anything, especially beautiful skins and snow-white meat.
I got him! I got him! There's the killing dart right there. It doesn't look like much, but you can dispatch a beast like this with it. Actually, that thing will kill a whitetail. It's just all about dart placement. You wait for the animal to give you the perfect shot, and you put it right in the vitals. Ha! They say they taste like chicken. Well, we're gonna find out.
The